sounds like it was a wild night last night on Capitol Hill. The House passed this formal rebuke of President Trump, the first in more than 100 years. This resolution condemns the president's racist tweets that went after those four congresswomen of color. And the vote fell largely down party lines. Just four Republicans and one independent joined Democrats to condemn the president.
Now, the vote itself was actually delayed for nearly 2 hours amid a bitter partisan debate over whether Nancy Pelosi, Speaker of the House, had actually violated House decorum rules by calling the president's tweets racist on the floor. Now, that led to this moment with Congressman Emanuel Cleaver, who was presiding over the House.
We don't ever, ever want to pass up, it seems, an opportunity to escalate. And that's what this is. We want to just fight. I abandon the chair.
Okay. Congressman Cleaver joins us now. Good morning, Congressman.
Good morning.
Why did you throw down your gavel and march away from the chair?
Well, because, frankly, I was embarrassed to remain as the chair presiding over what should have been a very shameful moment for all of us, and that is, here we were in the House of Representatives, and every person who spoke violated the House rules. I presided, I was asked to preside, to try to make sure that it was a fair kind of a thing, and that's what I did. So I admonished every single speaker, Democrat and Republican, and thought, all I want to do is get through this ugly situation without adding any chaos to it. And then, of course, the motion to take down the words of the speaker, I thought were just a total disgrace, because I could have set the stage to take down the words of other Republicans who had spoken, but I just wanted to get through it without embarrassing us anymore.
But explain that to me, because Nancy Pelosi was punished for her words. I mean, I think that she was sort of rendered silent for a little while, but who else violated the rules? What did they say?
Almost everybody who came up violated the rules. The actual legislation, the title in the legislation violated the rules. Racist was in the title of the resolution. And then if you look at the footage, just about everybody who came up there said what Nancy Pelosi said, that the president's words were racist. Including Steny Hoyer. Unfortunately, it was an opportunity for people to escalate, to make things worse, to make things messier, because I think for some people, there's some enjoyment. Now, Representative Collins is a good and decent guy. I think he was put in a situation where it's our opportunity to get Nancy Pelosi, and that's who they wanted. What I'm trying to say is, There were other individuals, including Republicans, whose words could have been taken down. But my goal was, this is ugly, it's embarrassing internationally, it's embarrassing to our children. Let's just get through this. Yeah. And we were about 5 minutes from getting through when somebody decided to take down the words of the speaker.
And Congressman, what do you mean by embarrassed? Can you just expound on that?
Well, I don't know if anybody can look at what's going on here on Capitol Hill and think that it's okay and think that it's the normal way in which legislatures conduct themselves. I mean, as I mentioned earlier and yesterday, that people want to escalate. I mean, we're in a bad situation now. I'm just thinking about my children and the children all around the country. And here are the adults on the floor. Think about the irony here. We're entertaining a resolution in which the president, to condemn the president of the United States for saying words that are just, in 2019, unthinkable to fall from the lips of the presidency. And so we're, instead of just dealing with that now, we're trying to deal with the words of the Speaker of the House, who is trying to condemn the president, hoping that he would stop using this toxic language. Of course, he's not. My understanding, he's quite pleased with the way things happened yesterday. I'm not. I was embarrassed as a legislator in the United States House of Representatives. Can you imagine what the world is thinking as they watch this dysfunctionality here in Washington?
Are you saying that you are now embarrassed to be a member of Congress?
Well, everybody ought to have some of that embarrassment, but I was certainly embarrassed to preside at a session where the goal was to make things worse. And I didn't want to be a part of it. And of course, Nancy Pelosi did violate the rules of the House. So did Cindy Carter, Sawyer. So did some Republicans, just about every Republican who spoke. But if we wanted to go down that road, we would have, we'd still be there, and we'd still be in the midst of all kinds of chaos. My goal was to get through it without any, without adding to the insult.
But when you say it was the goal of some people to make it worse, who are those people?
Well, the people on the Republican side, I think, are the ones who moved to strike, to take down the words of Nancy Pelosi. I just want everybody to understand that if you look at the footage, everybody who spoke could have had their words taken down. I'm saying it was a design to do that, to take down the words of Nancy Pelosi, not anybody who violated the rules.
But, I mean, why is there a rule that you can't say the word race, that you can't say that the president's words are racist? I mean, isn't that a little limiting if you want to call the president's words racist?
Well, you know, when you think about it, some of the great orators of all time have stood in the will of the House of Representatives. It is supposed to be a dignified spot, a place where Webster and Lincoln addressed touchy issues of those moments. And so the rules were put there to make sure that it was a, that the House is a place of dignity, where you can come in and have very, very serious debates without debasing the House. Now, that rule is put in the House rules books, and that rule can be changed. And we haven't, it hasn't been used since 1984 anyway with Tip O'Neill. Almost the identical thing happened.
So, Congressman, we're almost out of time, but what are you going to do the next time the president tweets? What do you suggest? I mean, since you think you all wasted a day and that it was embarrassing, what's your suggestion for the next time this happens?
Look, all of the chaos that's taking place here in Washington derives from one human being and the tweet. And I think, you know, we're having government by tweet, legislation by tweet, debate by tweet. And I think at some point, we, the legislators, as well, frankly, as the media, they let the president just tweet away his presidency. But we can't continue to react to this. I mean, he's going to insult some others. He's going to speak some untruths and so forth. We need to just let him hang out at the White House and do that. To the degree that we can still do some do legislation and get some things done, we ought to do it. My suggestion to the House and the Senate and the people of the country is to forget the man's tweets. I mean, I think he's playing us like a Stradivarius. He knows that there will be a reaction, and he also knows that a portion of his base is okay with him, you know, insulting people. And that's unfortunate for the United States of America.